spiritually. Now, you may not think you're paralyzed, and you may think that you're doing whatever, and to each his own, because it's now a matter of opinion, right? A matter of who you think is this, that, or the third. Mm-hmm. Only you know within self, right? And in your quest for that. But my thing is, like, when you're moving forward, if you've been giving tools, right, that was given to you for a reason. Now, this, then, like, I don't believe that, you know, I'm not a believer that slavery happened by osmosis. Like, it was a plan. Right? It was, somebody had a plan. And we know that that plan goes all the way up to the top. If we look at the financial records of the Pope, you know, back before the 1600s, we know that those plans go all the way up to the top, where somebody had a plan for the demise of these people. And, like, why, though? You know, why was it that when, you know, there's slavery that's happened all around this world, and then, you know, why are we, as, you know, the people from the continent, you know, or, you know, whatever, you know, because some people don't think they're from America. They think, I'm from America, and that's cool, you know. We all are from America from that, you know, perspective. But how can you move forward if you haven't psychologically released that weight? You know what I'm saying? Like, if you haven't released the weight of all of that implanting, those being implanted with tools for you to be submissive. Like, you know,
well, the bishop had mentioned, he said, well, first of all, we have to open ourselves up to be able try and heal.
How do you open yourself up when you've been, go ahead, Bishop.
Well, Bishop, what it has become is a stronghold. A stronghold is described like vice grip, something that's locked in. It has a strong grip. And it's going to take special technique, or
right,
to get that whole release.
Yes,
it's going to take wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. Because if you have some vibe grips right now, no doubt the kids, even, man, you say open this, they'll just be, you know, how can I move? Yeah, you know?
No understanding of how.
No
to do
understanding
it.
How to release the hold.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's a hold on the mind.
Yes,
it's at a set place, and strongholds can be broken. And the Bible talks about, amen, the pulling down of strongholds. That's when it's going into the prayer and talking and communicating with God. We're going to talk about it when we get back.
We're
going to
talk about it, definitely. Yeah. We'll be back with more Shock Factor here on LA Talk Live. We're going to go ahead and take a quick break. I'm your host, Shaquem Williams.
I'm Momo.
And I'm Life.
And we'll be back with our incredible guests. We want to thank them for such love and all of those things like that. But stay tuned with more Shock Factor coming up at the top of the moment.
Often wonder if he could ever change his mental. Build on some things, gotta get off this corner, stuck in this box, and it's just a game.
It's a shame, it's a shame.
Live life to the fullest, you can see there's nothing to it. Just to do it, and things could change.
It would change, it would change.
Make it happen. The Jack was green, that's why he had a slow reaction. Scared to death, didn't wanna think outside the box. There's nothing left, cause the block is high. Build on some things, gotta get off this corner. Stuck in this box, and it's just a game.
It's a shame. But it's a shame.
Foolish, you can see there's nothing to it. Just do it, it will change.
It will change. It will change.
Why?
decisions. He never got a piece of his pie. Poor Jack.
Jack was stuck in a box, surrounded by
choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Do you suffer from degenerative diseases such as high blood pressure, diabetes, fibroid tumors, high cholesterol, genital herpes, or a plethora of other diseases that rob you of a quality life? If so, then visit the website of herbalist Tahuti Ma'atra at dhealthstore.com and open the door to natural healing at an affordable price. dhealthstore.com has over 1,800 products created by herbalist Tahuti Ma'atra, specifically designed to help you heal the natural and safe way. At dhealthstore.com, you'll find everything from herbal formulas and cleanses, such as Tahuti's famous Full Body Detox, as well as herbal teas, extracts, natural body butters, lotions, creams, children's products, hair care products, and of course, sexual enhancement products for both men and women. So visit the website of Tahuti Ma'atra, dhealthstore.com, or call toll-free at 1-888-823-9416. dhealthstore.com.
Oh, yeah.
You're now listening to A-Rod Music.
Yeah.
Who's unstoppable?
You better believe it. That hard hitting. Only way A-Rod Music know how to do it. Forever keeping it fresh. Yes. Go get them life.
Yeah, yeah. Welcome back to the Shock Factor here on LA Talk Live. I am your host, Shockin' Williams.
I'm Omo.
And I'm Life.
And that is Life, and we're listening to Life. That's right there. That's called the format. And that's hot every time I listen to that right there, Life. I just have to say, that's hot. Because right now we're talking about the format. We're talking about religion. We're here with the, you know, with the pastor and his beautiful wife and their wonderful family. And we are getting it in today here on the Shock Factor. I want to thank you guys for tuning in and staying tuned in to what I believe is a, you know, open and great discussion. It's going to get better as well, but I want to thank you for coming on in. We really appreciate that ultimately all day, every day, because we like to grow here on the Shock Factor. And thank you guys for coming in. Okay, so let's get back to it. So, Pastor, you were saying something, Bishop, before you left. You were saying something very important. Go ahead and finish that thought, if you can.
Yeah, we're talking about the stronghold of the mind.
Yeah,
having a person set in a way in a state of mind that I can't move forward. I'm at a standstill. I have no hope. They're hopeless. They're lost in the mind.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. They mind need to be renewed and delivered.
Yes.
Amen. That I encourage people to take on the Christ mind. Mm. Let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus. Christ Jesus brings liberty. It brings freedom. It brings you to a state of mind knowing that you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Now, I want to go back a little bit, going all the way back to Africa.
Mm, okay.
And you know, because you had a big question, and the whole nation is watching, listening, the whole world is listening. You know, how did we get in this mess? That's the bottom line. How did this happen? How did we even allow this thing to happen? How did we lose our place? Mm. How did we allow
at
someone?
The table.
That's it. How would we allow somebody to come in and strip us of our stripes?
Mm.
My God, we must have been at the dinner table and one watching.
Somebody stole that cornbread.
Took all the cornbread. Come on, somebody. But, you know, I have to take you all the way back to Egypt.
Okay, let's get, because while we're on Egypt, we're going to stay there. But go ahead, Pastor. Bishop, I'm sorry.
You know, Pharaoh and his army torturing God's people. You know, you're going to do what I say and you're going to just do us. We're not going to do God. You know, forget that God. Y'all not doing whatever.
Serve our gods.
But God proved himself. Mm-hmm. By delivering them, Pharaoh and his army was drowned in the Red Sea. So in other words, at that particular time, God helped, God intervened, God killed the problem. When Pharaoh's army was behind them and they was marching out, and as the Red Sea closing up on Pharaoh's army and allow God's people to come out to make their exit, they exit into a wonderful place. But the enemy got in again. And that's when they began to take all their gold and their silver and to melt it down.
Come on, Bishop.
And to make idol gods.
Yes.
And that's where the problem came in. When they began to worship idol gods.
Yes.
It's just like a spit in God's face. I deliver you. I brought you out. I prove to you that I love you. I prove to you that I'm with you. I prove to you with all facts in front of you that you have nothing to worry about. Just trust me and allow me to lead you and guide you in the way you should go. But instead, the enemy came in just like he did in the beginning, whispered in their ear and said, you know what? Listen, make your own God. Make your own God. Melt all your gold down. Worship this God. But the Lord God said, thou shalt have no other God before me. That was that's in the Ten Commandments. Thou shalt have no other God before me. So this is how we lost our place, by disobedience. Through disobedience. When they melt down their gold and made them idol gods, began to worship those gods, amen, that's when a curse came upon them. And they began to wander in the wilderness 40 years. They should have made their exit in 40 days. But because of disobedience, it took them 40 years to understand who God really is and what he's able to do.
So
it took them 40 years to go around the corner.
Well, you know, that's interesting that you spoke on Egypt.
Before you get into your opinion, I want to hear
opinion.
Pat, yeah,
go ahead.
That is your opinion, Pastor Angela, her take on it, because she's been trying to get into.
I totally agree with what Bishop was saying. You know, it's the idol gods. God said God is a jealous God, and so that I believe that that was also a start, a beginning of you know, God's anger, God's wrath upon those people. You know, if you look around the country, even now, I mean around the world, I'm sorry, you'll see like devastation all over the place. But when you know, a lot of times we begin to empathize with people, we feel sorry, why this, why that, we question God, why did this happen? But if you go deeper, you know, there's a lot of idol worshiping, idol gods, you know, being raised, as Bishop was saying, like, you know, for example, theirs was, you know, in the gold that they melted down and created their own gods. But, you know, there's a lot of other gods, you know, a lot of religion going on, but a lot of idol gods being raised, if you will. And God is a jealous God. And so when you when we question God, I would just urge people, encourage people to, you know, just take a look, just open your eyes. You know, God's word is true and God is not playing. If he said, I'll have no other God before me, he meant that.
That's true.
So,
you know, just back to Mo's point, I don't have an opinion about this per se. What I like to talk about is at least, like what I like to talk about to, not at least, but the most, is factual information.
Okay.
Right. So, you know, what's facts? Who's facts?
Right.
No one really knows.
You get in, the truth.
Let's, before we get into that, because we're gonna talk about Because if no one really knows the truth, then what are we doing? Now we're just walking on faith. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, and that's, you know, the one of the pillars of the Christian, religion. And to me, hey, to each his own, mm-hmm. right? First and foremost, whatever brings you closer to your creator, mm-hmm. that's what it's all about. Mm-hmm. Now, however you get on that road and on that path, that's cool. That's your path. That's your road. Somebody decide to take this road and path with you, you know, then that's your road. Then that's your path. You know what I'm saying? Because
what made you choose the path that you're on?
Well, I'm about
what
to
was t- it? What was it about the path that, because you said you grew up in the church and Baptist and your grandfather. What made you decide to go this way instead on this path?
Well, it's you know, I think many paths lead to the Creator. Right, me personally. But what led me to this path was that information. Now, Christians, or whether I don't, any particular religion, whether you're a Christian, whether you believe in Islam, why is those three religions particularly, let's get some education in, because we're going to talk about the history right quick. Mm-hmm. Why are those three religions so prominent around the world? Christianity, Islam, and Judaism. Right. Why have them three in particular been fighting so much, you know, since over 2000 years? Like, why have they been the three, the bangers, you know, of it all? But if you study and then there's what, you know, if you want to, you know, study the Bible and find that answer, you know, then that's your perspective. But if you study and go beyond or before the Bible was created and stuff like that, when I talk about our story. Our history. Now, in our history and what we believed on the continent, right? And you have to understand this because this is so, I think it's beautiful only because it's our story, right? So let's go a little bit back. You talked about Egypt. And one of the, you know, three figures or main figureheads in Egypt at this time or in ancient mythology, Egypt mythology, is Osiris, Isis, and Horus. Or Osiris' name is Asaw, and Isis' indigenous name is called Oset. And Horu is what they call, you know, the son of God. Mm-hmm. Now, this happened over 3,000 years before the birth of Christ. And let's talk about Horu. What is some of Horu's characteristics? Right now, this is our story about what we were doing before Islam came in and indoctrinated our people from the East and all the way to the West, before missionary Christians came in from Europe and indoctrinated our people and stuff like that.
Was this so, before God? Was it before God? I'm asking the question.
Before the name God?
The creator, God, whatever name you
omnipotent.
Allah. I'm just trying to figure out, because we're going back to history, so I just have the question. I don't know. I'm asking the question.
Once we look at the linguistics of it, the word God, it's a European name that we know.
Okay, well, the creator.
In particular, they had their own names for the Most High, or whatever. It doesn't even, to me.
Does it say what did they call the Most High?
Oh, we got a call, too. I got to take it.
I just want to know. I'm
going to tell you in 1 second. Caller, what's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hey, this is X-Man. I'm calling from Los Angeles, California.
X, what's up, my brother?
What's up, man? We're at the radio station, man.
Oh, you at the door. You had the downstairs. Let me get somebody to open the door.
I thought he was calling in to get on the discussion.
Right. Yeah. Don't hang up that phone.
Hey, man.
We're about to get into it. You just cut it all off.
Okay. We'll get somebody to open the door for you, bro. I don't believe it. I'm trying to find out
who God is.
Okay, so
that means somebody is at the door and trying to get in the spirit.
Yeah,
ain't nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, that's God trying to get in. Because God got to tell you something.
Somebody. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I'll come in and abide in him and he in me.
That's right.
God is knocking.
That's right.
So let's talk. You know, we were talking about Jesus, because Jesus seemed to be the most, well, he's the figure in the Christian religion and stuff like that, and who's called the Son of God and stuff like that, who have all these characteristics. And we all know the characteristics already, mm-hmm. so I don't have to necessarily go over them. But in our story over 3,000 years ago, you have to hear the characteristics of Horus, right? Horus was called, you know, Horus was born of a virgin, right? Isis, Mary. He was adorned by three kings. He had 12 teachers. He was baptized, you know, and went into ministry at the age of 30. He had 12 disciples. He was known to have miracles, do miracles like walking on water. He raised Lazarus from the dead, right? He was also known as the truth and the life and God's anointed son. He was known also as the good shepherd, the truth and the light. He was also crucified and buried. And in 3 days, he was resurrected. Now, you hear that story about, and this happened over 3,000 years ago.
And where you get that information? Like, we can go to our Bible to get.
Well, you can go any. It's on a wall on a temple.
Okay. But it's not like in a book or.
Well, books. Yes.
I mean, I'm trying. Like, if somebody's trying to get this information, well, you can just go and want to read it.
If you want to go, now. I mean, you got the internet now. Yeah.
I'll just say.
So if you want to go, if you wanted to go on the internet,
it's in the library.
It's all in the library. If you want to check up, you know, ancient, you know, Egyptian information and stuff like that.
Okay, got it.
It's abundant. It's definitely documented.
Okay.
But when you have these characteristics of Horus, he was, you know, it's incredible that, you know, a lot of people never heard of those characteristics. Now, at that time, you know, it wasn't the only one. Like, before 4 A.D. happened.
There was someone before Horus, too.
After Horus. Horus was, you know, the first so-called mythology that we had in reference to that. Now, if we want to go back to the ancient Sumerians way before Egypt, now, that's a whole nother.
Right, but that's before Horus. Right.
Well,
so do you think it's a story
before Horus?
Well, Sumerian culture is the oldest and ancient culture in the world. They were the first to do everything
that we seem to know about.
No, that's documented in history.
That we seem to know about. Well, it's documented in history.
Well, everybody depends on if you want to look at it from a scientific perspective or whatever. You know, it's your opinion. Once again, people choose to, like, I want to look at this book
right. And
say that whatever. That's your choice, you know. But it's not a point about whether it's whatever, what's right or wrong. Because I'm so far beyond what's right or wrong.
Right.
But what I'm at right now is like, here's the history of our story that we were telling for thousands of years. I'm talking about dynasty after dynasty after dynasty after dynasty. And it wasn't until the Romans, when the Roman Empire came in and conquered Egypt. Right. When they came in and conquered Egypt, right, under what did they call who they say Alexander the Great, right? He came in and burnt all the books and did all that he could, you know, in reference to but they kept some of the books and the information and some of the knowledge. But most of the knowledge is on the wall. It's carved on a wall. Still to this day, the story of Isis and her little baby Horus, you know, and what we know as the first Immaculate Conception story.
So the King James Bible, ultimately, you're saying the story was changed.
Well, we know that the story was changed. If you go to the Council of Nicaea of 325 A.D., and you know about Constantine, right? Constantine in this council had. It was the first council where they wanted to, at this time, because they was worshiping in the Roman Empire, Isis, right? Okay. They was worshiping Isis at this time, and Mithra. And what they ended up doing was, not Mithra, but they was worshiping Isis. She was the mother goddess. So when you see the Black Madonna, you know, when not the one that we've known, what we've seen, you know, if you go to Egypt, right, you see the real Black Madonna even underneath the Vatican, they worship the Black Madonna, right? You see Isis holding her baby, right? That was the first Black Madonna story. That was thousands and thousands of years before, the birth of the so-called birth of Jesus at 4 A.D. Right. And all I'm saying to you is back to the psychology, back to the history of it. Here it is that we have an African story, right, that happened over 3,000+ years ago. I think it was way, way more. But this is what the historians say, 3,000 years ago. But we won't believe it. We were told in the Bible that Egypt was a wicked place, right? Why were we told? Now, because I'm here I am.
So the Bible says...
Who wrote?
You say in the Bible says that Egypt was a wicked place?
Egypt is wicked in the Bible. So
can you find that for me?
I don't have a Bible on me, but I'm sure they just said it.
I mean, I'm not trying to be funny. I'm just, you know, if we're going to throw out information. I mean, but I just want to know where I can find it if I want to read it for I want to read it for myself.
I'm sure if you ask your bishop. And stuff like that.
The verse that says that Egypt was a wicked place.
Egypt was known, and in the Bible.
I think he referring to Pharaoh and the wickedness that happened.
The wickedness. Yeah,
happened through him and his.
You know.
Got it.
Even Sodom and Gomorrah. You heard about that in the Bible, mm-hmm. right?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Now, what we don't know is that these are places in Africa, right? And see, my whole point is this, and I was just this is my point. We didn't, who wrote the book? Who had the money to print the book, right? This is where I'm at. Who had the monies to print the books? Was black people printing books? I don't know. I don't think so. But I know we did some scrolls all day, every day, and they're still, you know, here to this day. But I'm saying when in Europe, when they were going through all this stuff, who wrote the books?
So who documented? So if we go back, so the question is who?
So if you
so
go
no one knows who.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do.
Who is it?
In 325, once again, go to Google this, please. Go to 325 AD in the Council of Nicaea, mm-hmm. right? And understand that.
But we're still, what I'm saying is we're still reading and looking at stuff that someone else wrote. So the bottom line is who.
But here's the reality, though. You want to know who, but if you go back to Egypt, right, you see the stories on the wall. That's all I'm saying. The same story that's
so
in the...
So who made up those stories? That's what I'm trying to get to. Like, well, we want to know who. So at the end of the day...
So if we talk about...
It has to be a creator. It has to be somebody wrote the who has to be
Let me tell you why before you go there. Like, let me tell you about why in African culture, why they did what they did, right? They believed, in essence, that, say, for instance, they anthropomorphized everything, meaning that their whole thing was based on the stars. Right. And the sun's movement in because when you said earlier that they worshipped these gods. Right. And that's what we were told. But they didn't worship gods. They believed. Let me just explain to you. They didn't worship in Egypt gods like the way we think. In Egypt, they had one deity. They believed in one God. Right. But they believed also that the God of the air, the God of this, was attributes of the creator. They didn't believe that this God is this God, and they believed that it was polytheistic and stuff like that, where they believed they had all these gods. That's a misconception based on the information that we were taught. Once we get to understand the information that the brainwashing that happened to us. So let me just go back here. Our African brothers and sisters believed in, say, for instance, the brightest star at this particular time was the star of Sirius, right? And this is so deep because what they believed in is that the sun had this journey, the S-U-N, right? And the sun went on the journey, right? And they monitored the constellations and they told stories. They didn't have TV back then, so the stars were their TV. So they monitored the sun because the sun gave life, right? They knew the sun was, they didn't think the sun was God, right? They thought the sun was an attribute of God, right? So they followed and mapped it. So what they ended up doing was realizing that approximately every 26,000 years, the sun went around our galaxy. And every 2,150 years, the sun went into these houses, right? These houses, what we know as constellations that's been anthropomorphized as Gemini, Aquarius, this, that, third, or the other. They didn't believe, once again, in, they wasn't polytheistic. They was monotheistic, right? And everything that I read. But the realize is that the sun went on this journey for 6 months where it died down in the sky, right? It died on the 22nd, on the 22nd of December, right? The sun appears as if it had stopped, right? And also, you got to also understand that Mary is a constellation called Virgo and stuff like that. They call it the house of bread. Mary symbolized a woman holding a sheet and wheat. And Bethlehem, right? Bethlehem was known as the house of bread. So once you start understanding that our people, before we get into this, we were looking up there, looking at the, you know, looking at the sun, pattern right, looking at the constellations. So the sun goes through this, you know, transformation where in, like in December, it seems like it gets weaker in the sky. And on the 22nd of December, it's at its lowest point. The sun, it seems like the sun stops moving south for 3 days. And it, within those 3 days, it's sitting by what we know now is called the Southern Crux. Now, we call it the Southern Cross. But it's the, it's a constellation. It's not what, not what I'm saying. You like, you don't have to believe it, but it's still to this day. The three kings was the, you know, the three stars on the Orion's belt that followed the sun on the rising. So on the 25th, right, this is what they taught. This is what our story and what we taught, because it had significant meaning, right? And on the 25th, it seemed like it rose from the cross, meaning that the sun died on the cross and it rose on the 25th. Now, those stories have been told for 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,000 years in Africa. And only time when it changed, only time when we changed is when we got invaded from somebody else. They took our story, right? That's why we feel it the way we feel it, because they took our story and made it their story. Now, I'm not saying you can believe whatever you want to believe. I get it. But until we understand the history of what really happened, it's not to take away from what you believe in. I'm not trying to do that, but it's just to add on to the gift that, you know, that our Creator has given us.
Shaq, I want to ask a question.
Please.
I want to understand what you're saying. Are you saying that you want everybody to acknowledge what you perceive to be that we've been brainwashed?
Well, I would say
into
this.
Into believing whatever it is that we believe, is that the bottom line?
This is what I say when I was speaking about the psychology of it. Mm-hmm. If I want to take some, and I want to have some slaves, mm-hmm. right? If I want to do this whole slave thing mm-hmm. and do it good, mm-hmm. I want to do it to perfection. Okay. I want to just make it last for a long time. I'm going to supplant whatever you were thinking, right, and give you and put something new in your brain. Why would I want slaves knowing anything that's going to make them realize who they really are? And I believe that they were children of the Most High, right? So why would I give a slave some information about anything?
What she said was right. Bottom line.
But let me ask you this question.
Okay.
You consider yourself a child of the Most High? You're taking a long time to answer that question.
You?
Who are you?
Do I consider myself a child? I mean, in this physical form, yes.
Don't think too hard about it. You believe in the Most High, right?
Yeah. I believe in the Creator, yes.
Okay, you believe in the Creator.
I believe in creation.
Over the years, this is a very creative world.
Right.
Just like we're creative. It's a very creative world.
Right.
Information goes in and out. Over the years, before you got here, before we all got here, it's been information going in and out. Mm-hmm. People who are telling the same stories you're telling these people right now.
Yes.
it's going to come a time where in life, we are going to have to decide where you going to go. Mm. Hold up. Mm. Let me finish. You got to decide whether subconsciously, consciously, wherever you are, where you going to go.
Mm-hmm.
Because ultimately, there are some things that you're not going to change. There are some people who are going to go about their way of life and their way of living the way they're living it. Why? Because it works for them. Mm. It works for their character. It works for their person. It works for their spirit.
Mm.
The information that you know and that you want to give them, they're really oblivious to it. Why? Because what they're doing works for them. For them to find out what it is you want to give them, that's going to have to be something that's planted in them to make them want to go seek that. It's going to be have to be something to happen in their life to make them want to go seek that type of information. Other than that, the way that they're living their life was working for them. If they can turn around and go to their prayer table, if they can go to the mountain and sit and fold and meditate, they can do it however, then that's the way they're going to do it.
Mm.
History does not affect them because what they're trying to do is go from right now.
That's it.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But how do you go from right now?
Choice, like I told you before. Mm. It's like what you can do, you can just decide, y'all people got to wake up and realize what the hell is going on. Pardon my French. Pardon me, my English. Y'all got to realize what the hell is going on. You can decide you're going to do that, or you can decide that you're going to take what it is that you have, maximize it, and be able to reach back in a way where it's feasible for the next person.
I totally agree with those sentiments. And like I said before, I'm not here to change anybody.
I didn't mention change. All I did was mention like a choice to not. We can think about things so much, and yeah, we can be very passionate and emotional about a lot of subjects and a lot of things that we don't agree with or things that we've seen. But it's not about changing anybody. It's not about changing one person's views. But at the same time, it is about taking a look at yourself and saying, okay, I got that out. Now where am I gonna go?
The man in the mirror.
Well, you know, there's only one place to go, and that's always, you know, going within, right? And there's only one place. I don't believe there's anything outside of self. I believe that, you know, our Creator has, you know, made us good. I believe the Creator has given us all the tools that we need and given us a chance to go to the well and drink all day, every day. Now, you can drink whatever you want to drink. It's a choice, like you said. Right. I agree with that. But my point of this whole thing is not necessarily looking at it like, yeah, people are going to always do what they've been doing that throughout history, right? People have been doing what they do.
So there ain't no answer.
So, but the answer is that the more at the end of the day that
and that's not a bad thing always is that they're not just not an answer because all you can like I said do
there's
is
an
go
answer.
With what you have God at the end of the day.
It's gonna always come back.
And it's how you approach that lifestyle and your connection with Him. Mm-hmm. That's all it is. It's how you approach that your lifestyle and your connection.
Right. No, so I totally.
However you get it.
So now, so the question I have, Bishop. Listen to Shakim and to Life. To me, at the end of the day, these stories, the Egyptian story, the story, the King James version, all leads to one thing, the creation, which gets back to the one thing that everyone needs to get to at the end of the day, which is God.
Right.
That's it.
If you call him, and God has many names.
Right.
Exactly. Jesus has many names.
Right. Yes.
So no matter if you had called them Jesus or in the Egyptian story, you call them this, or if you're Muslim, you call them, you call them Allah. It all leads back to this.
To God. Yes.
So at the end of the day, we have to get to this.
Right.
How do we get to this?
You know, because there's always a conflict, because not even outside of what history says, there's always a conflict, because even within the Christian world or whatever, that, you know, they have conflicts too as well. You know, you go to some countries, no, his name is not Jesus, his name is Yeshua.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? Right. So there's always a conflict of information and what's true and what's not true.
But everybody knows God. Even atheists know everybody. God. Right. So how do we get to God? For somebody that needs answers, someone that is depressed, oppressed, someone that has all these questions, their life is not going well, they don't know what to do. How do we get to God?
Reach in.
Reach in.
Jesus is the answer. Jesus is the Son of God. This is what I believe. This is what the majority believe. If you look through history and even what Shark was saying, when it all boils down and it comes back. You might have different names for it, but it all boils down. Mary, baby, Jesus. Amen. And the Lord want men to come back to him, to acknowledge him, seek his face for direction for our lives so that we can know the way that we should go. Because there is an enemy out here. And that's one thing we hadn't talked about yet. The enemy is Satan. And Satan come to kill, steal, and destroy. But Jesus said, but I am come that you may have life and have life more abundantly.
I want to answer that too. When we come back, do we have a safe break?
No, go ahead. Go ahead. We're going to take a break in a couple of minutes.
Well, what I wanted to say I was going to actually add that. You know, I always advise, in my younger days, I was studying tapping a little bit into different religions because so many people, you know, such controversy, you know, is built around religion. And so what I always advise, just like you were saying, Mo, everybody acknowledges God.
Right.
If they don't acknowledge Jesus, you know, all the different religions or what have you, everybody there's God in their religion.
Right.
And so I always say, pray to your God, pray to God, and ask God for the truth. And when you pray to God, God is going to reveal the truth. Talking about all the facts and slavery and all that stuff. But bottom line is, there is a truth. There is a truth inside. You know, I don't care, you know, the slave master, everybody, you know, different. You were talking about the Bible and who it was written by and all that. So I've, in my younger years, asked God, show me the truth. Show me the truth. You know, I hear about all these things that went on.
Right.
The different opinion, the different writings and stuff, the different translations even. Lord, show me the truth. And so because we're all spirits, God has always bear witness to my spirit that this is the truth.
Right.
And you can't deny. You can deny maybe what's on paper, but you can't deny what happens in your spirit.
Right.
You can't deny the move of God in your spirit.
Right.
So I always encourage people, you want to know the truth, ask God what the truth is. And he'll bear witness to your spirit. He'll show you the truth.
Yeah.
So that's what I wanted to
ask. I concur with that.
Amen.
All right.
So before we take the break, are we wrapping it up?
Are we wrapping it up?
Or are we still
wrapping
talking?
We're going to
wrap it up.
I mean, this conversation.
This conversation has been going on
for millennia.
I had a question about, this is just touching on you guys' career. At what point was that turning point where the...
Oh, you came in late. He talked about that, but go ahead.
I came in late.
Go ahead. Ask a question.
Where did I miss the turning point at?
Ask a question.
Go ahead. You can use the late.
Did I not get here yet?
Yeah.
It's all right.
Well. It is well. Ask a question.
Go ahead.
All right. Well, I would just like to know where that turning point was, whether it was the point where you saw it, you just knew like, okay, boom, now we're about to really evolve, go to the next level, or that point where you just were contemplating, where do I go?
That's good. Ooh, amen. You know, I've in my, you know, we were talking about the scripture, too much is given, much is required. I understood my call when I actually was going through hell and back. I've been to hell and back. And, you know, I wondered throughout my life, you know, what is going on? You know, I've had prophets prophesy to me, you know, woman of God, you're going to minister to thousands of women and yada, yada, yada. And so as time went on and, you know, I was a single parent once raising my children. in my earlier years and just really going through. And I remember the Spirit of the Lord saying to me, you're going to minister. It's for the ministry. It's for my glory. And I remember yelling out, I don't care about that. I don't want to go through this. But it was at that point that I realized and I had to learn, you know, okay, Lord, you know, I submitted myself. Lord, if this is for your glory, then I submit myself. Lord, I'll go through it. And I understand that when we're going through, God is building us and God is doing surgery and shaping and molding us for his glory so that we will soar, if you will, and we will be able to reach back and help people and help those that have gone, that are going through what we went through. And so it was at that point that I decided, I don't know, God just gave me more power to submit myself and to humble myself and to understand who I was and to really understand my calling, you know. And then when I started ministering to women who were going through the same thing, I then said, Lord, okay, for your glory, I now understand everything that I went through was for this point. And if I can just help one person get through what I went through, if one, it was all worth it. So it was at that point that.
All right. Look, we're going to go ahead and take a quick break. Come back.
Okay.
Wrap this whole thing up.
Come on back.
We're going to wrap it up.
Come back.
That was powerful.
Yeah.
It was powerful.
Glory to God.
Yeah. Thank you so much for sharing that, too. Look, I'm your host, Shaq Kim Williams.
I'm Omo.
And I'm Life.
And we'll be back with more Shock Factor in a moment. Thank you for tuning in. We'll be back.
Suffer from degenerative diseases such as high blood pressure, diabetes, fibroid tumors, high cholesterol, genital herpes, or a plethora of other diseases that rob you of a quality life? If so, then visit the website of herbalist Tahuti Ma'atra at dhealthstore.com and open the door to natural healing at an affordable price. dhealthstore.com has over 1,800 products created by herbalist Tahuti Ma'atra, specifically designed to help you heal the natural and safe way. At dhealthstore.com, you'll find everything from herbal formulas and cleanses, such as Tahuti's famous Full Body Detox, as well as herbal teas, extracts, natural body butters, lotions, creams, children's products, hair care products, and of course, sexual enhancement products for both men and women. So visit the website of Tahuti Ma'atra, dhealthstore.com, or call toll-free at 1-888-823-9416. dhealthstore.com.
Are you ready to enjoy the Maui lifestyle? You can have it all by owning real estate on the Paradise Island of Maui. Dennis Rush, a 22-year Maui resident and real estate broker, brings his wealth of experience and market knowledge to add value to your Maui real estate understanding, providing a level of service as unique and exceptional as the island of Maui itself. The magical island of Maui was voted the most exclusive resort island in the world by Condé Nast Traveler, and keep in mind, Maui is only a simple non-stop flight away. Hawaii Business Magazine Top 100 Realtors awarded Dennis Rush the 2011 fourth top realtor on the island of Maui. Go to www.dennisrush.com to view all of the amazing properties currently available in the Maui MLS system. Whatever your needs or desires, Dennis Rush will provide a private consultation for any Maui properties your heart desires. You will be in good hands. Once again, go to www.dennisrush.com. That's www.dennisrush.com. Contact Dennis today to start your Maui lifestyle now. Dennis Rush, proud sponsors of the Dawn Christie Show and LA Talk Live.
Welcome back to the Shock Factor here on LA Talk Live. I'm your host, Shaquem Williams.
I'm Momo.
And I'm Life.
And we've been getting it in with some incredible guests here today talking about religion. I'm going to thank them for coming on in. We're going to go ahead and give them a stadium clap. You never know.
Stadium clap.
I enjoyed the love. I enjoyed everything in the conversation. I hope we can do it again, you know, because it's all about learning. We're going to go ahead and wrap this whole thing up. The GM came in. I know he was here. I thought I was waiting for him to get in. But he's here. And, well, you got to close it down.
Get out.
Before we go, is there anything that you, like a word that you want to give out or prayer for listeners that are listening? And
yeah, I want to encourage, thank you, Mo. I just want to encourage everybody to go deep down within yourself, as my wife was saying. Amen. There is a God in you, and he is the King of kings, and he is the Lord of lords, and he is the answer for every problem, every situation in your life. There is an exit for the tragic and all the different things, the trouble, the drama, everything that you're going through. There is an exit, and you can find that exit within you by asking God to have mercy upon you. Asking him to forgive you of your sins and look beyond your faults and see your needs. If you're in Los Angeles, you can join us Sunday morning at 10 o'clock. Our church is 5501 South Eileen, 5501 South Eileen. We're having service in the 54th Street Charter School. We encourage you to come out and serve and worship the Lord with us. And also, we have a prayer line where we pray every night at 9 o'clock. Amen. Every night, we have 1,000 lines open. You can call area code 712-432-0075. Area code 712-432-0075. Enter the PIN number 103602-POWN, 103602-POWN, or simply go to Bishop Derek L. Davis on Facebook, Bishop Derek L. Davis, and get all the information you need. If you don't mind, I'd like to pray a prayer of faith. Amen. Just a moment. Father God, I pray that you will bless your people on today. Lord, strengthen us all where we're weak, build us where we're torn down, and let your holy divine will be done in our lives. Forgive us of our sins, O God. Bless us today. Give us the heart and mind to come on in and serve you and worship you as we should. And I pray for those that have heavy hearts and, my God, heavy burdens on today, God. I pray that you are moved by your spirit and lift those heavy burdens, oh God. Yes. Heal the sick, raise the dead, give sight to the blind, cause the lame to walk in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And when I say raise the dead, I mean those that are dead in their spirit. Yes, my God, may you resurrect them. May you strengthen them and take them to higher heights and deeper depths in you. Yes. Heal them everywhere they hurt. You are a healer. You are a deliverer. Mm. And you are a way maker. You are a healer of cancer. You're a healer of all matters of sickness and diseases. Nothing is too hard for you. So I pray for your people. Give them peace, joy, happiness, and prosperity according to your will. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank God. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And anything you want to leave with, Pastor Angela?
God bless you all and be encouraged, saints. Be encouraged.
Thank you.
Yeah. All right. Such a pleasant, nice lady.
Glory to God. Glory to God.
That's such a beautiful spirit.
Yeah. Glory to God.
All right, guys. You got anything to say before we wrap it up?
Shout out to the Los Angeles Dolls. You can follow us on Twitter, Los Angeles Dolls on Twitter, on Facebook, on Instagram. I am Chef Momo on Instagram, Monique Moy on Facebook. Shock Factor on Twitter, Shock Factor on Facebook, and thanks for tuning in.
Yeah, thanks for tuning in. Most said it all. Thank you for our guest.
Yes.
Bishop and his lovely wife
thank
for
you.
Coming
thank
in.
Thank you. We're going to have you guys back. Shout out to Worldwide Ministries.
Right. That's right. Ministries.
Shout out to
Special.
All right.
Yeah, shout out to Myron and E. They single drop yesterday.
Oh, really?
Who was on the show a couple weeks ago.
Oh, nice.
Myron, yeah, they single and doing real well, so.
That's hot.
He said he's going to bring us the album soon.
Yeah, that's
okay.
Hot.
So the single drop, so shout out to them.
Right.
Had to give a shout out. And, yeah.
All right.
Shout out to Dave and to Rich.
Dave and Super Rich, too. And Princess
and to D. Ness, Princess D.
I came and sat in her spot, and she hadn't been back since, so.
She was over there listening, like, okay, okay. Yeah.
Princess D, shout out to her, too.
And she's happy birthday to my goddaughter, Cheyenne. She turned 17
happy
today.
Birthday.
Happy birthday.
Shout
happy
out
birthday.
To Cheyenne,
Greg. We're good. You want to give man
Los Angeles Dolls, too. Yeah, shout out to them, too. Los Angeles Dolls.
Definitely Los Angeles Dolls. My co-host, Life and Mo. I want to give a lot of love and thanks, you know, to the bishop and his lovely wife for coming on and blessing us with all the love. Thank you so much.
Thank you for your time. We appreciate it.
You know, I want to thank LA Talk Live for giving us this time as well. Super Rich and the whole staff of LA Talk Live. Our producer, David Brett, always bringing the love and stuff like that. Princess Diesel, she's back. We really appreciate that. I want to thank all you guys for tuning in, all of the almost 307,000 people that tune in to the Shock Factor. Every Friday here on LA Talk Live, we want to give you love and praise and thank you for your time and positive energy giving it to us. And also check out Shock Him and Project DNA on iTunes. I Am Human. And also thanks for my mom, my family. Thanks to Jen Tapiero. She always show love. Thank you, Jen and StarCam and all like that. And just chilling with Jen and the whole staff of LA Talk Live. Thank you so much for tuning in. We'll see you next Friday. Same time, same sandbox. Peace and blessings, and stay positive.
Be safe. Money Mayweather.
Thank you.
I had to get that in. Money Mayweather this weekend. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
God bless you all.
Sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
chick. I love my chick. And she can get it.
I love my baby. Yup, yup. I love my boy.
I love my chick.
I love my baby. Yup, yup. I love my boy.
I love my chick.
I love my baby.
I love my chick.
I love my baby.
I love my chick.
I love my baby. He bring me joy.
I love my girl cause she knows she the shit.
Wait a minute.
Swagger kinda ill and she ain't scared of the stick. Got her own cake though she act kinda rude. Does she know my money long? She spend her dough on a dude. Real life chicken wanna mess with the thugs. Sip a martini quick and wanna sex in the club.